ladies and gentlemen, I hope y'all are having a fantastic day. I know I am. I'm alive and kicking, can't complain. Now I'm super excited to share this video with you, and in order to understand why, you gotta know a little bit of my hunting history. Now I first started hunting when I was about 11. My weapon of choice, air guns, BB guns. My quarry, varmints. We're talking about sparrows, doves, starlings, etc. From there I progressed to predators, and I loved it. I was hunting bobcat, fox, coyotes, absolutely loved it. But as time progressed, I moved on to big game, and I was hunting elk, deer, bear, I got into waterfowl, I got into upland game.
You gotta be kidding me. Everything you just said is my favorite thing to do every day.
And I put aside air rifles and varmints and predators. Now it's funny how in my hunting life, I've done a full circle. So you guys have seen some of my videos where I picked up my air rifles again and I'm hunting varmints. But now I have rekindled my passion for predator hunting, only this time with air rifles. So what you guys are gonna see today is my first successful predator hunt with an air rifle. Now I do have a few air rifles and each one has a specific job. The one I chose to be my predator gun is my favorite gun. And that one is, this is the fxcrown MK2 in 30 caliber. She does have a 500 millimeter barrel with the Donny FL Sumo moderator to silence her. That thing you see hanging on the moderator is my homemade windicator, which works well. I did upgrade her bottle to a 580cc. I also added a Picatinny rail so that I can mount my UTG bipod. She also has the Eaglevision Infinity scope rings with the Athlon Midas TAC scope and the side shot camera mount. Of course, you know where I got it from, your boys in Utah Airguns. Now when I tell people I hunt with a 30 caliber air rifle, they struggle to comprehend the actual size of the 30 cal pellet. So, decided to show you, here's a penny, there's a 30 cal pellet. Your typical pen. Your 30 caliber pellet gives you about the diameter, or the entrance wound, the diameter of a pen, roughly. Now my pellet of choice is the FX pellet in 44 grain. Now I did say 44 grain. For those powder burners who like shooting 22 LR, your typical 22 ammo is between 30 to 40 grains. So this pellet here weighs more than your 22 does. Now I do apologize, the footage isn't terrific. I was super excited. Again, I'm rekindling that passion of predator hunting, so I'm caught up in the moment, but I promise you the footage is gonna get better. I am gonna continue predator hunting with air rifles, so expect better videos, but here we go. All right, I got about 2 miles to ride in to a spot I scouted last time. Riding my mountain bike. Let's go.
I'm safe when I'm resting, furniture in my nesting, not by force I'm suggesting, you count your blessings. I've got love and assurance, I've got new health insurance, I've got strength and endurance, so I count my blessings and give thanks to the master,
that through all the disaster, we're still here together after. Better count your blessings.
Count your blessings. Cause yo, this year, can't wait till it gets here. 72109, my first son will shine. And it's amazing, I'm about to be raising another made man. And like his dad, they'll praise him. And some will hate him just cause we building a nation. Like Bob did with Damien, the world will embrace him. Girls will chase him. Foresee they will not break him. And when I'm not around, you look for God and thank him.
That was awesome. We just called in a double. The first one was at about 80 yards, what I calculated for. I aimed for the head, and as soon as I pulled that trigger, I saw the yoke drop. I haven't confirmed, but about 2 minutes later, magpie started flying around right in that area. So I'm pretty sure he's down. We're gonna go check him out in a little bit. What sucks is we called in a second. We did a double. This one came running in and went straight to the call. I calculated he was closer than 80, so I aimed for the neck, but he was actually further because it hit, well, he was at 80 because I hit exactly where I was aiming for. He did a little spin, dropped, was kicking the grass around, laid flat. For 6 minutes, we continued calling right in front of the call, maybe about 10 yards away from the call. And all of a sudden, about a minute ago, he just got up and took off running. Unexplainable. That has never happened. I know I hit him, dropped him. He was kicking on the ground. He stopped kicking and then laid there for 6 minutes and got up and left. Never seen that happen, but we're going to go check it out, see if there's any blood, see if we can trail him. I'll bring my dog over, see if he can find him. Let's go look. All right, so just so you can kind of see the terrain we're hunting in. Heading over to the dropped yoke. Hopefully, he's down. Right in there, I see some fur. I think I got him. And yes, it's confirmed. My first yo with the air rifle, baby. He's down. Let's go take a look. Yeah, I want things to go my way. But as of late, a lot of shit been going sideways. And my mother tried to run away from home. But I left something in the car. And so I caught her in the driveway. And she cried to me. So I cried too. And my stomach was soaking wet. She only 5'2". All right, so we confirmed the first one. The second one. Still don't know what happened. If you can tell, this grass is pretty dang tall. I mean, look at, here's my knee. And when that yoke laid down, he was out of sight. So We're gonna go take a look to see if there's any blood somewhere about right there. I don't know what happened. Let's go look. All right, so we found where he was laying. He was laying right here. Okay, that's over there is where I was perched. This is where he was laying down. It's confirmed because I brought my dog over and she ran straight to this point and was sniffing the ground. In fact, we did find a piece of turd. Usually when animals are about to die, they lose their bowel movements, or they make bowel movements, and we did find a fresh piece of turd. So I know it was here, but there's no sign of blood or hair. So I don't know what happened. My dog did take off running that way. We're gonna keep following and see if we could find some blood or find a down yote somewhere out that direction.
All right, an update on the second yote. Couldn't find her. So I brought out Lonnie and let her out, got her excited about it. She went straight to where the yote was laying. We were able to find that scat, no blood, as I had mentioned already. Then she took off running, pretty much in the same direction where we saw the yote take off. And after following her, quit it. After following her, we did find some fresh scat. So that yote was deucing, it was hurting, but nothing. Took about an hour and no blood, no fur. Lonnie really worked the area, got away. Don't know what happened. Since I didn't get the whole experience on video, I'll quickly tell you how it went. We started calling. 2 minutes into the call, here comes this yote about 200 yards right in front of him, right in front of us, sorry. And he was an older yote. Instead of rushing into the call, he used the sage line and downwinded the call. As soon as he got downwind, he was facing the direction of the call. We did have a decoy there, so it got his attention, gave me enough time to aim for his head, took the shot, coyote down. The second one was younger because of the mistake he made. So he ran into the call, which sucks I didn't get on camera, because he rushed in, so you would have seen the whole coyote. You would have seen how quickly he ran in. He got up to about 10 yards from the call, figured something was up, and before he took off, I got him on that neck, shot. When the pellet impacted him, his head did buck back, and he turned around as if to run away. He ended up laying on his side and he started kicking on the ground as if he was still running away. Within seconds, he stops kicking and lays flat. The grass was about shin high, so as soon as he laid down, I couldn't see him anymore. We continued calling and for about 6 minutes. And at that 6 minute mark, this coyote that I thought was dead jumps up and he doesn't run away, but he hops out, and at every hop, he's breathing out a lot. So he was in pain. As a hunter, you never want, no matter what target you're going for, you don't want to injure animals. That's the last thing we want to do. So obviously I put in the time to make sure I can recover the animal that I shot. Sadly, I wasn't able to recover it. Whether you guys like coyotes or not, I try to respect all animals and I try to be an ethical hunter. Couldn't do it this time. Now, it was still a fantastic experience nonetheless. I am thinking about making a video showing you my predator hunting gear. I also want to make another video so that you guys can see the air rifles I have and the specific task or job that I got for each one of them. But again, that'll be another video. I am also, just to give you guys a heads up, I am also planning on making videos where I'm cooking some of the game that I have shot. No, I don't eat coyote, but I have had friends and family try bobcat and they say it's wonderful. I was kind of skeptical. I have had mountain lion, and mountain lion was delicious.
You're sick! You're sick! Why would you do that?
So next time I get a bobcat, I will try it out. But plan on doing some cooking videos so you can see what I actually do with the animals that I harvest with my air rifles. So stay tuned for that. And again, thanks for joining me on this video, on this experience. It was awesome for me. Hope it was awesome for you. Hope I get you excited about predator hunting, about air rifles, because it's a blast, literally.